If you want to know about health and have health concerns, then subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. You'll be notified about all upcoming videos.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Welcome back. Today we are going to discuss about indigestion. Indigestion is dyspepsia. Why it happens, what causes it, how you can treat it, and how it is actually different from bloating, gastritis, and other types of like heartburns and other things. So there is a very big confusion about what differences these things have, but today we'll clear all these doubts. So what is indigestion? Indigestion is a mild discomfort which you feel in the upper belly or abdomen, upper part of abdomen, and it occurs during or right after eating. After eating, it may feel like there is some heat or burning or pain in the area between the navel and the lower part of your breastbone, right between this area. It can be an unpleasant fullness also. It can start soon after you finish a meal or you begin a meal, or even if it can happen after you finish your food also. Bloating and nausea are very less common symptoms of this problem, indigestion. And indigestion is not the same thing as heartburn. Heartburn is totally different. Heartburn is totally different causes. It is the burning sensation which you feel in your food pipe, where your food actually comes up, the acid actually comes up and burns your esophagus, the food pipe. That causes heartburn, and that is different. The heartburn is most commonly seen in GERD, gastroesophageal reflux disease. So indigestion, what causes indigestion? Number one, see, most of the time indigestion is not a sign of a very serious health problem unless and until it is accompanied with some other symptom. Like if you have indigestion with a lot of weight loss, with any kind of bleeding, or you have trouble swallowing things, then only it can be a problem. That means it can have serious causes. Or even if you have sometimes heart attacks can also be mistaken for indigestion. So why does indigestion happen? What triggers indigestion? See, indigestion is caused by drinking too much alcohol. If you eat very spicy or fatty or greasy food, if you eat too much, overeating basically, or if you eat too fast, very fast eating, if you have any kind of stress or nervousness, indigestion can happen. Eating very high fiber foods and in a lot of quantity can cause indigestion sometimes. Remember, that's a side effect of high fiber diet. Smoking tobacco can lead to indigestion, and drinking too many caffeinated beverages, tea, coffee, colas, etc., etc., can cause indigestion. Other reasons of indigestions can be gallstones. If you have gallstones, if you have gastritis, actually gastritis is a different thing as compared to indigestion. Gastritis means that your stomach lining has become inflamed or swollen because of irritation, right? That gastritis can lead to indigestion, but these are two different things. So gastritis can lead to indigestion, but indigestion does not lead to gastritis. And then swelling of the pancreas, pancreatitis can lead to indigestion. Stomach ulcers, which is an ulcer on the stomach lining or intestinal lining, or these intestinal ulcers can also lead to indigestion, as well as use of medicines such as antibiotics, aspirin, and over-the-counter painkillers, right, NSAIDs. These can also lead to indigestion. So overall, indigestion is just a feeling of discomfort in the upper abdomen, right? And it can lead to a lot of, it may feel like burning pain, etc., etc., like I said in the initial part. So what can you do? How can you actually take care of indigestion? Here are some home remedies, which are very, very effective if you use it very, on time. Right. So the first and most biggest point here is changing the way you eat actually helps you. Changing the way how you can change. Number one is allow enough time for your meals. Take the time you have to actually to eat. Don't eat in a rush. Don't eat very fast. Chew your food. Second point is to chew the food properly, carefully and completely. Properly, carefully, completely chew your food nicely. Avoid any talking or arguments during meals, because obviously talking is not a problem, but then arguments, you will not have any concentration on your food, and you might end up eating fast or eating poorly. You might not chew your food. Then avoid any excitement or any exercise right after meal. Right after meal, you should not exercise if you have indigestion. For that matter, doing your normal routine work is not a problem. Okay, but exercising right after meal is not recommended for this particular problem, if you have this problem. Then if you have indigestion, which is caused by stress, then obviously you should relax and get rest for that particular thing. And if you take rest, if you follow these 5-6 golden rules, your indigestion will get control over a week or so, 1 week or two. Obviously, you have to stop taking antacids your NSAIDs, painkillers, if you are taking them. If you have to take them, then you take them on a full stomach, when your stomach is full, right? If you are taking antacids, your aspirin or painkillers, that thing. And you can take antacids, right? Tygene or any kind of antacid to relieve your indigestion. And medicines which you can take without even any prescription include those ranitidines, omeprazoles, pantoprazoles and other prazoles. You can take them, or even Digene or mucane gel, these can be taken, right? Then you can also be given prescription medicines at a higher dose for a long period of time by your doctors. So when should you go to a doctor? Should you go to a doctor? Yes, you should. If you have indigestion symptoms which change very noticeably and very frequently, then symptoms, if you have lasting for more than a few days with unexpected weight loss, if you have unexpected weight loss, if you have sudden and severe abdominal pain, if you have any trouble swallowing, if you have yellow color of your skin and eyes, basically jaundice, right? Then if you have any kind of blood in your vomit or in your stools, then you have to go and get checked for liver problems, heart problems, and esophageal cancers, etc., etc. So that's very important. How things are checked, ultrasound is done, basic ultrasound, blood tests are done, and sometimes an upper GI endoscopy is done to check your esophagus. That's how we come to know what is going on, what problem is going on, what is the issue. And then depending upon the cause, the treatment will be done by your doctor. The best doctor for this purpose, this problem, is gastroenterologist. So that's all about indigestion, dyspepsia, or that uncomfortable fullness which happens after eating. This is Dr. Paramjit. You're watching Dr. Education. Make sure to share this video and let everybody know what is the right information. Thank you so much. Stay connected. Stay healthy.